Right, guys, in this demonstration, I'm going to show you how to do a remix on the fly. Very simple. By the way, first of all, I'm using a tune by Mr. Kenny Hectic, track entitled Far Away. If you like it, check out a link in the description down there, take you to Beatport. So, first of all, on the fly. It's something that happens there and then, spur of the moment, just do it. So, a remix. You can do a remix of pretty much any tune. Modern day technology has enabled us to press buttons and twist knobs and turn things. Excuse me. That's better. Twist knobs and turn things so we can just have fun. So, what you will need, of course, is you'll need two players, and it's always a good idea to have some effects, but even if you have not got any effects, you can still do some form of remix by editing the beats and just mashing up the track. Now, a couple of things you will need. First of all, you need to make sure that you use the same track. Alternatively, what you can do is, if that track has got, say, a remix or an edit or a different version, different style, for example, you could have a house version and then there could be a breakbeat version. Just so long as they're at the same BPM, make sure that the same speed, you can just think out there and there and down there, not in here. That's wrong. In there is wrong. Think that way and that way and that way. Outside of that square thing. Then you can pretty much do anything. And again, if you do a remix on the fly and you don't think about what you're doing and you don't remember it, then it's unique. So then when you do it again, it's unique again and again and again, instead of like practicing at home and going, oh, here it is, and you're doing it. I should have hit the button then and I didn't. Oh, I'm gonna die, I'm gonna melt. Just be spontaneous. So, Mr. Kenny Hectic, let's have a listen to the track. What I've done over here is I've got one loop and I've set two hot cues. So on the hot cue, we've got a loop and we have two hot cues. There. And over there and here. And okay, so you don't even have to do an entire remix. You could pretty much mash up the first part of the track. So say, for example, track is playing here. You mix in the next track. This is the one you want to do your remix with. Then all you'll do, you'll make sure you've got the same file, or, like I said earlier, a similar, like a remix of it. Bung it on the other side, make sure the BPMs are correct, make sure it's in key, and then the rest is entirely up to you. So what I'm going to do is, the beginning of the track, I'm just going to like mash up the beats a little bit and have some fun with it. So if we listen to the beginning, this is the first kick. So we've got the first kick. Now just have a listen. This is where being a drummer or having a good rhythm is very, very handy. Thank you. you know, it could get a little bit monotonous, but it's about keeping timing. Now, what I would recommend here is maybe mash it up for like, I don't know, 16 bars, 32 bars, and then for goodness sake, let the track play. So, all right, let's just imagine I'd done that sort of mashup, a little bit of twisty, pokey, proddy kind of thing on the hot cues. And if I've done it on this side, then what I could do is on my headphones, go back over here. So imagine that's playing with the crowd are listening to that now, okay? They are, they're happy. They're just jumping around on the dance floor going nuts. Hazelnuts. And we're over here. Let's come out of the loop. You see what I did there as well? I had the low pass filter, turn it up a little bit. Right, hold on. Hold on. I want. Okay, we'll do it. So, what was I doing there? Right, I activated the delay, so that's flashing now, went 1/1, tapped in time, and turned the delay on, found a small part of exactly the same track, and just brought it in over this track. That was completely random. You know, sometimes while I do a video, I'm thinking, I'm bung it in. Which is exactly how you should be when you're playing in front of a crowd, all right? It's great to get a set together. Set works. But if you've got your... I'm moving in different directions now. If you've got your set together and that's the set you're going to play, it could rock. It could absolutely make the crowd go... Yes. Alternatively, if that's all the tracks you've got, and maybe... 5 or 6 tracks through that set, all of a sudden the dance floor seems to disappear. You're pretty much stuffed, aren't you? Because that's all you've got. So what you need to do is you need to think outside of that square thing. So again, what I'm doing here, I'm just sort of thinking, let's mash it up a little bit. Now, here's a fact. If it does go slightly offbeat, then don't panic, don't worry about it. What it means is that people, some people, not everybody, but some people will think, it went slightly offbeat. I remember the days when it used to go offbeat quite a bit, but it doesn't happen much more now. And those were the days when DJs used vinyl. That's all they had. No computers. And it was great. It was real. It was organic. Not orgasmic. It was as well, but it was it was real. It was fun. It was exciting. Now it doesn't happen much. No, I feel... No, it does, actually. Now it doesn't happen that much because everyone's using computers and stuff. I like that because it shows me that the DJ is being a real DJ. Okay? Bear that in mind. Kenny Hectic, love you. Practice and enjoy. Thank you very much. Check out there for his tune. Thank you.